Hello students, today we are going to discussing about galvanometer, types of galvanometer and applications of galvanometer. What do you mean by galvanometer? Galvanometer, it is an instrument used for detecting and measuring small electric current. It is a only one instrument to detect and measure a small electric current, that is called galvanometer. And there are two types of galvanometer, that is deadbeat or aperiodic galvanometer, and second one is ballistic galvanometer. We'll discuss one by one now. What do you mean by deadbeat galvanometer? A deadbeat galvanometer is a moving coil galvanometer in which the coil is wound on a metallic conducting frame. It is known as deadbeat galvanometer. Why it is called as a deadbeat? The question is, why we can call it as a deadbeat? It because it gives a steady deflection without producing any oscillation. For that reason, we can call it as deadbeat galvanometer. A deadbeat galvanometer, moving coil galvanometer, in which a coil is wound on metallic conducting frame. Metallic conducting frame is called deadbeat. The reason we can call it as a deadbeat is it gives a steady deflection without producing any oscillation when a steady current is passing through the coil. For that reason, we can call it as a deadbeat or aperiodic. The other name is aperiodic. That is called deadbeat or aperiodic galvanometer. The second one is ballistic galvanometer. We can call it as BG. Okay, that is BG. What do you mean by BG, ballistic galvanometer? The galvanometer is used to estimate the quantity of the charge flow through it. The ballistic galvanometer, which is used for estimating the quantity of charge flow through it, is called ballistic galvanometer. The main working principle of ballistic galvanometer is very simple. It depends upon the deflection of the coil, which is directly proportional to the charge passes through it. Okay, it is directly proportional to the charge passes through it. Okay, I will repeat once again. What do you mean by galvanometer? Galvanometer is an instrument used for detecting and measuring small electric current. This is the only one instrument we can detect and measure the electric current. Very small range. Okay, there are two types of galvanometer, that is, one is deadbeat galvanometer or aperiodic galvanometer, and second one is ballistic galvanometer. What do you mean by deadbeat galvanometer? As I told that, why we can call it as a deadbeat, because it gives a steady deflection without producing any oscillation when a steady current is passed through the coil. Okay, suppose this moving coil galvanometer, means the coil is wound on metallic conducting frame. Wound on the metallic conducting frame, that is called deadbeat or aperiodic galvanometer. And the ballistic galvanometer, which is used for estimating the quantity of the charge flow through it, is called ballistic galvanometer. The working principle of the ballistic galvanometer is very simple. It is depend upon the deflection of the coil, which is directly proportional to the charge passes through it. It's called ballistic galvanometer. These are the two types. Now, the main universe syllabus, the main topic is ballistic galvanometer. That is, we will discuss about what is the theory of the ballistic galvanometer. In order to explain the theory of galvanometer, as we already discussed the both the types of the galvanometer, But in ballistic galvanometer, it is an ordinary galvanometer, or in ordinary galvanometer intended to measure the strength of steady current. The main, all the galvanometers, what are the ordinary galvanometers available in the market now? The main theme is to measure the strength of the steady current, to measure the strength of the steady current. But a ballistic galvanometer is intended to measure the quantity of the charge that passes quickly through the coil, not as a steady current, but as the sudden discharge, for example, in the discharge of the capacitor and in electromagnetic induction. Such thing we can call it as a ballistic galvanometer. As I told that the main working principle of the ballistic galvanometer is very simple. That is depend upon the deflection of the coil. Which is directly proportional to the charge passed through it. That is the main principle. When a current is passed through the coil, suspended freely in a magnetic field, it experiences a force in a direction given by the Fleming left hand rule. Okay, this is the physical diagram of ballistic galvanometer. This is the laboratory instrument. We can see in the, suppose if our offline class will be started, in that time we will definitely will show the busy experiment, ballistic galvanometer experiment. This is the internal structure of the ballistic galvanometer. Okay, in ballistic galvanometer, suppose this is the inbuilt diagram. Suppose I consider a rectangular coil. This is a rectangular coil of n terms. There is a n number of terms, and there is a uniform magnetic field, that is north and south pole here, a uniform magnetic field that we can call it as a B. And there is a length of the coil, is assume that L is the length of the coil and B is the breadth. Now what is the area of the coil? As we already know that area is equal to length into breadth. And when the current passing through the coil, suppose when a current is passing through the coil, the torque of the coil, torque we already discussed in last semester, torque, that is symbol is tau. The when the current I is passing through the coil, the torque is always the depend upon the number of terms n, and applied, that is a current passing through that coil I, and applied magnetic field and area of that coil, that is the torque value here. The torque tau is equal to n is the number of turns, and I is the current I, B is the magnetic field, A is the area. If the current passes for the short interval dt, okay, in earlier this while find out the torque here, we don't know the time here, just apply the time, it is short interval dt time, okay, that dt tau into dt is equal to n is number of coils, number of turns, that I is the current, B is the magnetic field, A is the area, and dt is the time, okay, time taken. Suppose when some current is applied for to this coil, how much time we are passing that current, that is dt. Suppose if the current passes for the t second, assume that t is the time, t second, instead of mentioning 10 to 20 30 40, you just assume that t second, the total angular impulse of the given coil is, for if you apply for the t second, in that time you are applying for the integral 0 to t, tau into dt is equal to 0 to integral of 0 to t, that is just n b a I dt. Okay, n is the what, number of turns, and b is the magnetic field, a is the area, I is the current, into dt. Suppose n is a constant and b magnetic field is a constant, area is constant, n b a, just take it outside, and 0 to integral of 0 to t I into dt. This 0 to integral of 0 to t I into dt, we can call it as a charge, that is we can call it as a q, that is a total charge passes through the galvanometer. Total charge passes through the galvanometer. Now let the I be the moment of inertia of the coil, I be the moment of inertia of the coil, and omega, what is the meaning of what do you mean by omega? Omega is the angular velocity. As we already learned, angular velocity, angular momentum, torque, all the things we have already learned in the first semester. Okay, omega is the angular velocity. Then the charge in angular momentum of the coil is, that is applied current I into omega. Okay, as we already know that angular momentum I into omega is equal to, that is depend upon the number of turns, magnetic field, area and charge, that is N B A Q. Okay, call it as equation number 5.4. Then the main kinetic energy of the moving coil system, the main kinetic energy formula, we know that half into what is half into I omega square. Okay, I omega square used to twisting the suspension wire through an angle theta. Suppose C be the restoring torque per unit twist of the suspension wire, then what do you mean by work done? Work done is equal to half C theta square. Now okay, what do you mean by C? That is the restoring torque per unit twist of the suspension of the wire, that is theta is the angle. Okay, that therefore of the, just assume kinetic energy is equal to potential energy, this potential energy, that is work done. Okay, kinetic energy is of I omega square is equal to work done, that is of C theta square. This half and this half get cancelled here, I omega square is equal to C square, that we can call it as a 5.5, equation called 5.5. Okay, now the period of oscillation of the coil is, the period of oscillation of the coil is that time period t is equal to, that is standard equation, that is t is equal to 2.2 square root of I by C. Okay, or just squaring on both side, that is t square is equal to, t square is equal to, that is 4, that is just I am squaring here, that is 2 square is nothing but a 4, and pi square is pi square, and square root and 2 get cancelled here, remaining only I by C. Just I am writing t square is equal to 4 pi square C by t. Therefore just I need the current value here, just keep it I as it is here. Okay, I as it is here. Now send this C to this side, that is t square by C divided by 4 pi. This is the exact current value. Just multiply this equation I is equal to t square C by 4 pi square to this equation. Okay, I am just multiplying here, this I square, this is, there is only one I here in this equation 5.6, in this equation 5.5, this is I omega square here. I square omega square is equal to C square t square theta square 4 pi square. Okay, multiplying this equation, or just apply the square root for entire this equation here, that is square and square root get cancelled, remaining only I omega is equal to C t theta divided by 2 pi. Okay, just I'm applying the square root here, square term get, everything get cancelled here. Okay, just equating equation 5.4 and 5.7, just this equation we can call it as a, name it as 5.7. Now 5.4, which is a 5.4, that is I omega is equal to N B A Q. Okay, N B A Q, and this one I omega is equal to C T theta divided by 2 pi. Okay, just I am equating, that is N B A Q is equal to C T Q divided by 2 pi. I need the value only for charge here, that is Q, just Q keep it as it is here. Just remaining all the term, that is C by 2 pi, take it outside here. Okay, T by 2 pi, just C keep it as it is in the numerator here, N B A just take this side, and theta take it outside. This you can call it as Q is equal to 2 T divided by 2 pi C by N B A theta, call it as a equation 5.8. This gives a relation between the charge flowing and the ballistic through theta of the galvanometer, that is Q is directly proportional to theta. Okay, q is directly proportional to theta, but here t by 2 pi and c divided by n ba is called the ballistic reduction factor k. Okay, this is you can call it as a k. Now q is equal to k theta. Q is equal to k theta. Now what is the damping correction in the galvanometer? Okay, in the damping correction, suppose the ballistic galvanometer is moving in this direction. Okay, it is oscillating in sine wave. This is oscillating. Now the upper direction is theta 1, down is theta 2, this is theta 3, and this is theta 4, and this is theta 5, and so on. Suppose if theta 1, theta 2, theta 3 are the successive deflection observed, okay, this is a successive deflection observed, it found that is theta 1 by theta 2 is equal to theta 2 by theta 3 is equal to theta 3 by theta 4 is equal to so on, this is we can call it as a d. D is the constant, it is called decrement of the swing, and lambda is the logarithmic decrement. If the d is equal to, that is as I told, d is the decrement of the swing. If d is equal to e to the power of lambda, I need the lambda valence, that is just I'm removing the exponential term here. That is, if you are removing the exponential, lambda is equal to logarithmic base e into d. I am also removing that lambda is equal to log theta 1 by theta 2. What is the theta? Theta is the angle, and lambda is the logarithmic decrement. Decrement in one swing, if you go this value, it is only one swing, that is theta 1 by theta 2 is equal to e lambda. If it is two swing, that is theta 1 by theta 3, the difference is 1, that is theta 1 by theta 3 is equal to theta 1 by theta 2 into theta 2 by theta 3, okay, is equal to e to the power of 2 lambda. Okay, suppose in n swing, if you keep on moving, if you are writing up to n swing, that is one swing, second swing, up to so on, up to the n swing, that is theta 1 divided by, this is theta n plus 1, whatever the values we are coming here, that is plus 1, that is theta 1 divided by theta n plus 1 is equal to e to the power of n lambda. Suppose if it is n swing is e to the power of n lambda, if it is half swing, that is e to the power of lambda by 2, okay, e to the power of lambda by 2. If theta is the true deflection, theta 1 is observed 1, then theta divided by theta 1 is equal to e to the power of lambda by 2. Okay, then theta is equal to, just cross multiply here, theta 1 is equal to e to the power of lambda by 2, or theta is equal to theta 1 into 1 plus lambda by 2, that is removing the exponential term here, thus neglecting the higher order power, that is lambda by 2, just neglecting that one thing. Then if you are writing, suppose exponential term, if you, how you are going to remove the exponential term, suppose e to the power of x in term is equal to 1 plus x, x square divided by 2 factorial plus x cube by 3 factorial. Just I am neglecting the higher term here. Just instead of e to the power of lambda, that is 1 plus lambda by 2, directly we are writing here. Okay. Now we want to determine the lambda here, that is, as we already know that what is the value of q here, that q is equal to t divided by 2 pi c divided by n b a. Okay, the c t divided by 2 pi n b a theta 1 into 1 plus lambda, or this is the theta value. I am substituting the theta value where here this is the, we can, this is the, I am substituting this value, theta value here, this equation 2 divided by 2 pi c divided by n b a. Okay, NBA, okay, the theta 1, theta value is theta 1 into 1 plus lambda by 2, okay. This allow the coil oscillate and observe the number of successive swings for the 8th swing, okay, that is theta 1 divided by theta 9. Suppose I'm just writing the up to the 8th swing, that is, you just apply the formula theta 1 divided by theta n plus 1, that is n is the 8 here, that is n plus 1 is theta 9 here, and e to the power of 8 lambda. Suppose lambda is equal to 1 divided by 8 into log theta 1 by theta 9. This is the final expression. This is the theory of blast galvanometer. Okay, kindly go through, all of you go through this, and if you have any doubt, please get back to me. As I told that the working principle of the ballistic galvanometer is very simple. It is depend upon the deflection of the coil, which is directly proportional to the charge passes through it. Okay, charge passes through it. Okay, this is the physical diagram. All of you go through the derivation. This derivation. If you have any doubt, please get back to me. Okay, thank you.